Well, with all the talk about the acquisition of football clubs and the rich getting rich and the poor getting poorer, the fact that this is the first ever competitive match between Hearts and Ross County does point to the two worlds which exist even in our own relatively small country. So Ross from the north and their 1,500 supporters away in the background there are on an excursion to prove that the haves and the have-nots can pursue exactly the same goals. I hope they enjoy themselves. Well, Jim Jeffries has placed his trust in the same 11 who fell ominously flat against Kilmarnock that last game we did on Scotsport, and I'm sure that brief international recognition in Lithuania will do no harm to Neil McCann. Ross County remain unbeaten and have only conceded one goal since the start of the season. By any standards, that's superb. And the night he beat Dundee United in this competition is now compared up there in Dingwall to the night they invented champagne. But success breeds its own pitfalls, and sadly, the coach Neil Cooper tells me that if their top goal scorer, Derek Adams, plays well tonight, it may be his last game for the club, because he's been pursued by no fewer than 8 clubs, predators from both sides of the border. The last to look at him was Middlesbrough. Well, if you watched Jim Jeffries being interviewed on Scotsport last night, you... Good run forward in Hearts, looking lively immediately. There's the Ross County support in there at the back, making almost a carnival evening of it, and you can hardly blame them. Dare I say that many of them will be rather surprised they got to this level. Well, maybe not. And an out they break Ross County. Neatly done again. Ferguson coming away with it, back there by McBain. There's no offside. This drifted forward there and touched inside. Here's a great chance for Ross. Oh, it's off the bar. A shot by Escalon, the best chance of the game so far. It's still not cleared. And it's tucked on there by Adams. And what an anti-climax after by far the best move of the game. Just look at the way they ripped the much more experienced defence apart. He took it with the side of his foot. There was a lot of angle and spin in it. There's a warning posted clearly and delighting these supporters from the north. Anything like that to them is a bit of a bonus, and here was something deserving of a goal. Difficult ball to take. Kept it down as well as he could. There were defenders in front of him, and that angle was very acute. And forcing Hearts into basic errors in defence. And at least that is an achievement. Neatly touched on, he's a great chance, it's in! It's a goal by McBain, there might have been an own goal touch in that, and they have gone berserk. You can hardly believe it. Ross County have taken the lead 5 minutes before half-time. And that Hearts defence, absolutely bamboozled. Look at them, they're quite astonished. The ball goes in here, in comes McBain. Presley reaches out, but it is McBain who got the final touch. The ex-Dundee player coming up here, that should have been covered. Look at Presley, off his knee. An initial and basic fundamental blunder, thoroughly punished. He took it well, he was very cool, and I do believe that Rousset could not understand why he had been left. Here's McCann. Have to do better than that. They do need a break goal. Can it be? Yes! Holmes has done it! The man who scored against Raith Rovers at long last. The siege has paid off. Oh, it's a red card. Well, something happened off the ball. It's their first red card of the season. Explaining what went on there, it was certainly an incident off the ball, and look at the Hearts bench. Five minutes left. There's McBain with a shot, brilliantly saved by Rousset. That could have won the game for... into a bit of a lottery, and the manager is not to take a penalty kick. It's got to be about conviction, and it is. It's got to be the top goal scorer, Derek Adams, to take their first penalty for Ross County, and he's missed it. There must have been enormous pressure on this young player. Well, he certainly hasn't broken down and wept. Now Fulton. And Hearts are now two up. Nice sporting booze in the background. Just to aid in the system. He really needs to put this away. Well, I think the occasion has turned out to be too much. Nickel now going forward. That's it. Will it be a final save by the Frenchman as David Ross steps forward? They haven't scored, and that is an ignominious end. Hearts have reached the semi-final.